Often the death of someone we know sparks a need to think about our own mortality. It is not a common topic of conversation, but it is an important one to have. And even when a loved one has decided he or she would like to be buried back in their homeland, which is actually the case for many families in the Latino community, what are the options? What are the costs to plan for? And what are the resources available? To give us some insight on the subject matter, we've invited David Casper, international shipping expert for Casper Funeral and Cremation Services, which is a family-owned Massachusetts cremation and international funeral shipping provider that has been in business for almost 90 years. And they are also the largest international funeral shipping in all of New England. Welcome to Revista, David, and thank you for stopping by.
Thanks for having me. Yep.
It is a conversation that needs to happen, but doesn't happen often enough, right?
Well, it's inevitable. Everybody's, sad to say, going to die. And it happens too frequently when someone dies and the family doesn't know what their options are, and then they find out afterwards that they could have shipped their family member home. So we try to help them out.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about that, because you've had this experience a lot in the Latino community. I know you ship all around the world. But Dominican Republic, Central and South America, what are some of the destinations that you've seen that you're working with lately?
Well, just this week alone, we shipped to San Juan quite a bit. Yeah. And San Juan is actually very easy to ship to, because it's like shipping to Texas. But when you ship to Guatemala or El Salvador or the Dominican Republic or even Mexico, each country has different requirements to ship a family member home. And that's one of the things that we are very good about, dealing with the consulates and regulations and making sure everything goes smoothly. Mm.
And now you guys are located in South Boston, but you do this globally, right?
We do the whole state, and to the point that we have people coming from New Hampshire and Rhode Island for our assistance, because this is what we do, this is what we specialize. And when your family member passes away, you don't want to pick a funeral home and all of a sudden be their test case.
Yes. I hear that. So tell me a little bit more about these decisions. When someone wants to send a family member over, what are some of the factors or things to consider, kind of the checklist of things?
Well, most importantly, hopefully everyone's feeling well right now, but the reality of it is you've got to talk to your family. Yeah. And the reason you have to talk to your family is, just this week alone, I have two scenarios where I have half the family wants to ship someone home and the other half doesn't. And the family will come in and go, hey, I'm the oldest son, I get to make the decisions. And you go, no, it doesn't work that way. Everybody's equal from a child's standpoint. So you really should try to figure out what you want to do and try to put it in writing, so if something does happen, it supersedes what
that, that's a good are. Tip, because I can see that happening, right? Some of them want them here, some of them want them shipped back.
I'd love to say every family gets along, but sometimes they don't. Yeah. And the reality of it is some family members are still back home and some are here, and nobody wants to say goodbye, and so you really want to find out what your wishes are going to be.
Yeah. In terms of planning for it financially, what are some of the tips that you can offer?
Everybody always assumes to ship back home to any of these countries, you're going to spend $10,000, $15,000, $20,000. It's not like that. What'll happen is, depending on what you want to do here and the type of casket that you purchase, sometimes just for our cost, even if we went to church, you can still figure things out for under $4,000. And then you have to deal with the airfare. And as far as the airfare goes, if it's Puerto Rico, obviously it's a little bit less expensive, but if you're looking at Guatemala, El Salvador, Dominican Republic, you're looking at around $1,350. So you can get to ship someone back home for under $6,000, compared to the least expensive cemetery in the Boston area, which for buying the grave, digging the grave, and a cemetery liner right off the bat is $3,165. Mm-hmm. Before you even start talking to me. Mm-hmm. So are you saving money? Not really. Mm-hmm. But that's a family decision.
Yeah. How did you guys become the experts in shipping?
About 15 years ago, people started changing how they did funerals. It used to be, you know, someone would die, would have the day wake, and then have the burial, and that was it. But over time, people said, well, we're either going to have a simple cremation, or since we live in Boston, people will come here, and they don't want to be buried in Boston where they have no relatives. They want to go home. Mm-hmm. And we have three staff members who speak Spanish.
Okay.
And one of their family members passed away, and we shipped them to Dominican Republic. And after we did it, I go, this isn't too bad. And then they started recommending us, and it started to kind of spiral. And then even we got involved with the Mexico consulate, and they started recommending us. And it's just word of mouth, and it kind of grows and grows. And once you get into communities, they stay with you and they trust you.
Yeah, so they know you. They know Casper in the Latino community.
My Spanish is not great, but my staff members, their Spanish is excellent, and they take very good care of our family members.
You guys are located, let's put your Casper, right, funeral.
Well, we're in South Boston, and we're right next to the South End, and a lot of times people go, South End, Casper's, but there's no funeral homes in the South End, and a lot of times we'll rent out churches in that area or other areas to fulfill the funeral wishes.
Yeah. What's the best way to get in contact with you guys?
Well, you can always call us at 617-269-1930, Casper Funeral Home, or our website is casperfuneralservices.com.
Well, we've got the number up there, 617-269-1930. Hey, Dave, nice to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you as well.
Good name, Dave Casper, yes. The old Oakland Raiders tight end, number 87.
Big fan of Notre Dame, not the Raiders.
You were Notre Dame, yeah.
Yes.
And I heard he wrote to you.
He did. He sent me one of his cards when he played at Notre Dame.
That's a good story. I like Dave Casper when he was with the Raiders. I was a Raiders fan growing up. But
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay.
All righty. All right. Coming up next, you'll actually meet two of this year's crop of young and talented interns who work behind the scenes and who will be making their television debut right here on Revista Hispana.